O'Donnell, and I'm a graduating senior in environmental science at the University of Florida. I was selected as a university scholar to partake in a year-long research project with algae at the Bioenergy and Sustainable Technology Lab with my research advisor, Dr. Ann Wilkie, under the Soil and Water Sciences Department. I additionally completed my honors thesis on algae this year. So working in the lab as a university scholar was very enjoyable and a great learning experience. When I first started, I actually had the intention of researching the methane potential of different types of animal manure. So I had helped outside with the algae ponds a few times, but it never really struck an interest for me. The moment that really changed everything was when another student actually showed me the algae under the microscope. So I was amazed and just fascinated by all the intricate and detailed shapes that the algae could form. And outside in the pond, they really just look like little specks in green water. But when you view them under the microscope, that's what really made me eager to study them. So that's a great advantage to this program. I was actually able to interact with other students and see what they were researching. And so that's what really allowed me to spark this interest in something that I never even thought I would be interested in. So after I had examined much of the literature on algae, I learned a lot about the environmental benefits of producing algae. So for example, they can be used as a feedstock for bioenergy. They can be used as a sustainable animal feed because algae can be grown in areas that are unsuitable for agriculture. So it's not directly competing with our cropland. Additionally, algae are incredibly efficient at removing nutrients, which help to keep our water clean. So they remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and then convert that into their biomass, which is what my project focuses on. So my research involved a type of filamentous green algae called Odogonium, which if you look under the microscope, filamentous algae actually appear as long, thin filaments. And filamentous algae differ from microalgae because microalgae, when you look under the microscope, they appear as teeny tiny little cells, whereas the filamentous, you can see them as long, thin filaments. So it's very differentiable just looking at them under the microscope. And so in my experiments, I wanted to compare the harvest productivities of Odogonium, the filamentous algae, to different species of microalgae. And this is because harvesting Odogonium is much, much easier than harvesting those teeny tiny cells of the microalgae, which might help to reduce the production costs if they are going to be produced in the future. So outside, there are multiple 1,000 liter raceway ponds, and one of them was inoculated with Odogonium species, and two contained established cultures of microalgae and were used as a comparison to the growth of Odogonium. So each pond received carbon dioxide to assess and compare their productivities. Every week, I took pH and temperature readings of the ponds. Then I harvested the ponds, took samples, and took them into the lab to filter them in the vacuum filtration system. Then I dried them in an oven and then weighed them to determine harvest productivity and culture density. So I also looked under the microscope to see if there were any physical changes to the way that the algae looked from week to week. And after about 6 weeks, the Odogonium actually seemed to have a competitive advantage over the microalgae and appeared to be a suitable species for production. So overall, research has taught me an incredible amount about thinking intuitively and working independently. Not every question had a correct or obvious answer, and sometimes I had to think off of my feet and make educated guesses about certain scenarios. So working in a lab has also taught me how to take samples, how to analyze data, take photos on a microscope, create a literature review, and then publish my results in a research paper and present those results to other people at different research symposiums. So it's been an incredibly rewarding experience becoming involved in research that could transition our society towards a more sustainable future. And I highly recommend this experience to anybody that's interested in research. Thank you for watching.